Take a look at the animation that is being played. In this animation, a chessboard has been taken and a king piece. Now you will notice that as the king piece is being moved, the image of the king piece is moving along with it. You will see that if the king piece is kept two squares from the mirror, the image is also kept two squares from the mirror. If the king piece is moved absolutely to the back of the chessboard, the image of the king piece also moves to the back of the chessboard. So how do you think the distance of the king piece from the mirror is related to the distance of the image from the mirror? Let us find out. In a plane mirror, is the distance of the image from the mirror always equal to the distance of the object from the mirror? Here we are going to prove that these two distances are equal with the help of ray diagram. Now, consider the diagram being shown on the board. Here, O is the object, I is the image being formed by the object, and this, denoted by P, is the plane mirror. Now here we are going to consider two rays. One incident ray is going to be incident normally. Since this wave is incident normally, the angle of incidence is zero. So according to the laws of reflection, the angle of reflection will be zero. So it will be reflected back along its path. And we are going to consider another ray that is incident at an angle I, which after reflection moves in this direction. So the two rays that we are considering are OD and OB. As you will notice that OD is the incident ray which after reflection is retracing its path, and OB is an incident ray which after reflection is traveling as BA. The observer is placed at A. Here, in order to obtain the image, we are extrapolating these two rays and getting the image I. Now, we consider that the angle of incidence is theta. So, according to the laws of reflection, the angle of reflection will also be theta. Notice that BN is the normal at the point of the incidence, which means BN is perpendicular to the plane mirror. So angle DBN is 90 degrees. This angle is 90 degrees. So we can say that angle DBO is 90 minus theta. Similarly, angle DBM is also 90 degrees. And now notice angle NBA, that is the angle of reflection. It is theta. Now, angle NBA is vertically opposite to angle MBI, and vertically opposite angles are always equal. So angle MBI is also theta. So that makes angle DBI minus theta. So here we have the angles as I just mentioned. Now we have to prove that the object distance, that is OD, is equal to the image distance, that is ID. Now consider the diagram. Here, in order to obtain our proof, we have to consider two triangles. Triangle BOD and triangle BID, that is triangle BOD and triangle BID. In these two triangles, as I mentioned, angle BDO, that is this angle, and angle BDI, this angle, are equal as both are 90 degrees. angle OBN, that is this angle, is equal to angle ABN, which is this angle, as angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. And thirdly, angle ABN, that is this angle ABN, is equal to angle IBM, that is this angle is equal to this angle, as they are vertically opposite angles. Now we already know that MN is perpendicular to the mirror. Why? Because it is the normal at the point of incidence. So what can we conclude now? We can say that angle OBD and angle IBD are equal. Why are they equal? Recall, as I mentioned, that angle DBN is equal to angle DBM. Both of these are 90 degrees. Now we know that angle OBN is theta, the angle of incidence. So if OBN is theta and angle DBN is 90, so angle DBO or angle OBD will be 90 minus theta. Similarly, we can say that angle DBI will also be 90 minus theta, because this angle, that is angle IBM, is theta and angle DBM is 90 degree. Thus, angle DBI will be 90 minus theta. So these two angles are equal. We can also say that BD is equals to BD. Why? Because line BD is a line that is common to both the triangles. And lastly, we can say that angle DOB is equal to angle DIB. That is, this angle is equal to this angle. Why? Because, as you know, the sum of three angles in a triangle is always equal to 180 degrees. So if we need to find the value of this angle, we need to subtract the sum of these two from 180. So that will be 180 minus the value of this angle is 90 plus the value of this angle, that is 90 minus theta. This gives us theta, because 180 and 180 cancel out. So angle BOD is theta. Similarly, in triangle DBI, if we consider the sum of angle DBI and angle BDI, we come up with a similar calculation, and thus we can say that angle DIB is equal to theta. So angle DOB is equal to angle DIB. Now, as we can see, we have a pair of angles that are equal, a side that is common, and another pair of angles that are equal. So what can we say? We can say that triangle BOD, that is triangle BOBOD, is congruent to triangle BID through angle side angle congruency, or ASA congruency. Now, since these two triangles are congruent, we can say that side OD is equal to side ID, because corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. So we can say that OD is equal to ID. And what was OD? OD was the object distance. And what was ID? ID was the image distance. So what can we conclude? We can thus conclude that for a plane mirror, the distance of the object from the mirror is always equal to the distance of the image from the mirror.